हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फॉर द लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य वी हैव स्टार्टेड द एक्सरसाइज 8, ओके, चैप्टर फ्रैक्शन. वी आर इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द एक्सरसाइज 8, ओके. सो टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 10th वी हैव सॉल्व. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल्स इन दिस एक्सरसाइज 8, ओके. सी यू. What is question number 11 to 15? There is one common instruction for these questions. Question number 11 to 15. Before that, open your book, Xerox, which I have given. In question number 11 to 15, use proper sign from less than, equal to, or greater than in between the pairs of numbers. Means what? These examples number 11 to 15 are based on the comparison of fraction. We have learned the comparison of fraction in regular maths also. Three types of comparison we have learned: when denominators are same, when numerators are same, and when both the numerators and denominators are different. So all those three types of comparison we have learned. Now see here, question number 11. 6 upon 9, 5 upon 7. These two fractions are there and we have to check which fraction is greater or which fraction is smaller. Okay. Now, if you'll observe that their numerators are not same, their denominators are also not same. That means this comes in the third category. That is, the fractions having both the numerators and denominators different. Okay. Now, see here. When the fractions having both the numerators and denominators different, in that case, how we compare? Using cross multiplication method. Okay, so see here. Cross multiplication method means the numerator of the first fraction multiply with the denominator of the second fraction. Whereas on the right hand side, denominator of the first fraction multiply with the numerator of the second fraction. Okay. Now 6 sevens are 42 and 9 fives are 45. So between these two products, 42 and 45, which is greater? 45. That means 42 is less than the 45. Okay. So this side, the product on the right side is greater. That means if you write those two fractions as it is, 5 upon 7. So which fraction is greater? 6 upon 9 is less than the 5 upon 7. That means 5 upon 7 is greater. Understood? Next. 1 by 2, 2 by 3. Again, no same denominator or numerator, no same denominator. Both the numerator and denominators are different in the given two fractions. So same method we have to use. Numerator of the first fraction multiply with the denominator of the second fraction, and denominator of first fraction multiply with the numerator of second fraction. Okay, so 3 ones are 3, 2 twos are 4. 4 is greater, 3 is less than 4. So 1 by 2 first fraction is less than 2 by 3. Okay. Next. 15 upon 24 and 5 upon 8. Again here, numerators and denominators are totally different. But see here, we can use here cross multiplication method. By that method also we can find. But there is one idea, shortcut. So we will go by that shortcut. Which is that shortcut? See, if you observe this 15 upon 24 and 5 upon 8, see here, if you observe this 15 upon 24 and 5 upon 8, this numerator and this numerator, is there any relation between them? Are they, is 15 in table of 5? Yeah, right? And 24 is also in table of 8. That is 5 3s are 15, 8 3s are 24. So if you divide, means 15 and 24, both are divisible by 3. 15 divided by 3, 3 5 is a 15 and 3 8 is a 24, okay? And here also we have 5 upon 8, right? 15 upon 24 and 5 upon 8, they are nothing but equivalent fractions. So when we divided both the 15 and 24 by 3, we got 5 upon 8, this fraction itself, right? Means 15 upon 24 and 5 upon 8 are equal. That means the 15 upon 24 means it is one of the equivalent fraction of 5 upon 8 only. So 15 upon 24 when converted into lowest term, we got 5 upon 8, which is equal to 5 upon 8. So 15 upon 24 is equal to 5 upon 8. This thing also you have to keep it in mind while comparing two fractions. You can check whether they are equivalent fraction. Then if they are equivalent fraction, then it our works become very easy. Not need to do the cross multiplication. Okay. Next 14th one, 17 upon 102 and 13 upon 91. Here also see here. Instead of doing cross multiplication, how we'll do, you know, both 17 and 102. 17 and 102 are divisible by which common number? Both numerator and denominator, that is 17 and 102, are divisible by which common number? Can you tell me? Both the 17 and 102 are in which same table? They are in table of 17. So let's divide it by 17. So 17 ones are 17 and 17 six are 102. Okay. Whereas our another fraction 13 upon 91, 13 and 91, they are also divisible by one common number, which 13 itself. Both 13 and 91 are in table of 13, okay? So see here, 13 ones are 13, 13 sevens are 91, okay? Okay, see now, here we have got 1 upon 6 and here 1 upon 7, the two fractions having same numerators. So when there are two fractions having same numerator, in that case the fraction having smallest denominator is the greatest fraction. So 1 by 6 is greater than 1 by 7, okay? Understood? So in this way we have to compare the two fractions. We have compared here in the first two we have used cross multiplication method, whereas here also we can use cross multiplication method, but better to that we can go by this way also using ideas. Okay, so wherever possible we can use like this ideas, wherever possible. Here it is possible. So we divided by both the numerator and denominator by 3, and the surprisingly we got here same fraction. So it is equal, not need to do the cross multiplication. Here also see, both numerator and denominator are divisible by one common number. So we divided both the numerator and denominator, okay? So we got 1 by 6 here, 1 by 7, same numerators, two fractions with the same numerators, and it becomes easy to compare the two fractions having same numerators, okay? So we have done in this way. Question number 15, solve by yourself. Understood? Okay, now pause this video, write this in your notebook. Okay, after that we will see next questions. Then see, in question number 16 to 20, write down the LCM of each pair of number without elaborate computation. We have to write LCM of the given number. Question number 18. 8 and 23. Question number 19. 6 and 9. क्वेश्चन नंबर 20, 11 एंड 14. नाउ सी हियर, इन दीज एग्जांपल्स व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू फाइंड देयर एलसीएम. वी हैव टू फाइंड देयर एलसीएम. वी हैव लर्न टू फाइंड एलसीएम यूजिंग प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड और शॉर्ट डिवीजन मेथड. बट इन दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाट दे हैव आस्क्ड, फाइंड द एलसीएम बट नॉट यूजिंग अ कंप्यूटेशन. डायरेक्टली वी हैव टू फाइंड एलसीएम. डायरेक्टली मीन्स व्हाट, नॉट यूजिंग एनी मेथड. ओके, सो हाउ टू फाइंड द एलसीएम और विच इज दैट ट्रिक टू फाइंड एलसीएम. लेट्स सी LCM of 7 and 9. LCM of 7 and 9. So, see here. Out of these two numbers, 7 and 9, one number is prime number. Can you see? Between 7 and 9, which is prime number? 7. Okay. So, whenever we have to find LCM of two numbers, out of which one number is prime, one or two numbers are prime. In that case, the multiplication of two numbers is only their LCM. So, when one of the number is prime, at that time, their LCM means what? Their multiplication. 7 9s are 63. 63 is LCM of 7 and 9. If you are doubt, you can check. 63 is the smallest or least common multiple of both 9 and 7. 7 9s are 63. 9 7 is 63, 7 9 is 63. So 63 is the smallest number, smallest common number, which is in table of 9 also and 7 also. Understood? How we found it directly? One of the number is prime, so we their multiplication means only their LCM. Okay? See here, 12 and 21. 12 and 21. Now, out between this 12 and 21, is there any prime number? No, there is between these two number there is no one prime number. Now, if there would be prime number, we would have multiplied them to get the LCM. But here, out of these two, nobody is prime. Okay. So what we will do, you know, in these two numbers, which one is greater? 21. You know, LCM means what? The number which is in table of these two numbers. The number, such number which should be in table of both these number, but it should be lowest. Okay, so we will write table of the greater number 21. 21 ones are 21. Okay, is 21 in table of 12? No. Then 21 twos are 42. Is 42 in table of 12? No. 21 threes are 63. Is there 63 in table of 12? No. 21 4s are 84. Is there 84 in table of 12? Yes, 84 is there in table of 12. So 84 is in table of 21 also and 12 also. And it is the lowest common multiple of 12 and 21. So LCM of 12 and 21 is nothing but 84. So why they have given this question to find LCM directly short in using shortcut? Because this concept of finding LCM orally or directly without using any method, this we are going to use in the addition and subtraction of fraction. Okay, so pay attention carefully, understand it. 8 and 23, find the LCM of 8 and 23. So between 8 and 23, 23 is prime number. So whenever there is prime number, one of the number is prime, multiply them directly to get LCM. 8 into 23, that is 8 threes are 24, 8 twos are 16 and 2, 18, 184 is the LCM of 8 and 23. Okay? Next, 6 and 9. Now 6 and 9, there is no one is prime number here. So in that case, say table of 9. 9 ones are 9. Is there 9 in table of 6? No. 9 twos are 18. Is there 18 in table of 6? Yes. 18 is there. 18 is in table of 9 also. 18 is in table of 6 also. And it is the lowest common multiple. So
LCM of 6 and 9 is nothing but 18. Shortcut.
This is the shortcut to finding LCM.
Then 11 and 14. 11 and 14. 11 is prime number. So multiply directly. 14 ones are 14. 4 will come down. 1 will be carried. 14 ones are 14 and 1. 15.
154 is the LCM of 11 and 14. Not need to use any method. While finding this LCM, we haven't used any method. Whether prime factorization method or short division method, we haven't used. Directly we have found whenever, see, if one of the number is prime, directly multiply those two numbers to get the LCM. And both the numbers are not prime, then what we have to do? Write the table of greater number till we get the such number which is in table of that smaller number. Understood? Pause this video, write this in your notebook. Next question. Okay, see you. Perform the indicated operations in question number 21 to 25. So in question number 21 to 25, if you'll observe, there is addition and subtraction of fraction. 3 upon 7 plus 4 upon 9. Five upon 12 minus 4 upon 21. 5 upon 8 plus 2 upon 23. 4 upon 9 minus 1 upon 6. Okay, first 4 we will solve. See now here, addition and subtraction of fraction. Till now, that is till last year, we have done addition and subtraction of only like and unlike fraction. Means where? Denominators were same. Sorry, we have done addition and subtraction of only like fraction, that is where denominators were same. So this was the basic principle. Keep it in mind, the basic principle of addition and subtraction of fraction is we can add or subtract the fractions only when their denominators are same. When we can add or subtract the fraction? When their denominators are same. For example, see, 4 upon 9 plus 3 upon 9. This we can add. How to add? Last year we have seen, when denominators are same, so we can add their numerators. In fraction, we add only their numerators. Denominator we take common. Denominator we do not add. Okay, so 4 plus 3 7 upon 9, or 5 upon 12 minus 3 upon 12. Subtraction, but when denominators are same. When denominators are same, take denominator common, subtract only numerator, that is 2 upon 12. Okay, so when we can add or subtract the fraction when their denominators are same, like this. Okay, and we add or subtract only numerator, same denominator we take common. Understood? Now if you'll observe these examples, their denominators are not same, their denominators are unlike, not same, the fractions are unlike. So what to do? See, we want same denominator, So if the denominators are different, we have to make them same. If the denominators are different, we have to make them same. Okay. Now the question arises that here denominator is 7, here denominator is 9. We have to make them same. Now the question arises that how to make the denominators same, right? So to make the denominator same, we need to find their LCM, which we have found in the previous question. LCM of 7 and 9. What is LCM of 7 and 9? 7 is prime number, right? So 7, 9 is 63. 63 is the LCM of 7 and 9. Now, what to do with the LCM? Using LCM, how to make the denominator same? See here. First fraction right here, 3 upon 7. Now what we have to do, you know, here denominator is 7. We have to convert the denominator equal to the LCM. Means LCM is 63. So we have to make denominator 63. Whatever LCM we will get, we have to make the denominator of the given fraction equal to the LCM. Okay, now here denominator is 7, we have to make it 63. So here there is 7, to make it 63, by which number we have to multiply 7? 7 nines are 63, 7 nines are. So we have multiplied denominator by 9, and according to the rule of fraction, when we multiply any number, when we multiply denominator by any number, by same number we have to multiply to the numerator also. Okay, so as we have multiplied denominator by 9, we need to multiply to numerator also by 9. This is the rule. Okay, understood till this? Plus 4 by 9 take down. Here also, in the second fraction also, we have to make denominator 63. Now the denominator is 9, we have to make it 63. Then by which number we need to multiply 9 so that it will become 63? 9, say 9 double till you get 63. 9 sevens are 63. Okay, as here in the denominator we have multiplied by 7, in the numerator also we need to multiply by 7. Understood till this? Okay, once again I repeat, pay attention very carefully. 3 by 7 plus 4 by 9. We have to add two fractions, but according to the principle of fraction, when we can add or subtract two fractions, when their denominators are same. Here denominators are not same, they are different, 7 and 9. So to do the addition, we have to make their denominators same. To make the denominator same, what we have to do, we have to first find the LCM of both the denominators, 7 and 9. We found LCM 63. Now we have to make denominators equal to the LCM. Now here denominator was, in the first fraction denominator was 7. To convert 7 into 63, we multiply 7 by 9. Okay, as we multiply, since we have multiplied denominator by 9, so we need to multiply numerator also by 9. Similarly, here we wrote this 4 upon 9 down, and to convert 9 into 63, we multiply 9 by 7. So to the numerator. Now perform the given operations. 9 threes are 27 upon 7 nines are 63 plus 4 sevens are 28 upon 9 sevens are 63. Got the same denominators? Now we can add the numerators. Now see, denominator take common, add numerators, 27 plus 28. Now 27 plus 28, 56, right? Or 55 upon 63. 55 upon 63 is the addition of 3 upon 7 plus 4 upon 9. Understood? watch again. I am not going to repeat again. Watch this video again. Why we have found LCM to make denominator same? Okay, we have to make denominator equal to the LCM. So LCM is 63. So to make denominator 63, we multiply 7 by 9. Here we multiply 9 by 7 to both the numerator and denominator. Okay, then we got denominator 63, and accordingly here in the numerator we got 27 and 28. And when denominator is same, take it common and add only numerator. Don't add denominator. Understood? See next. Subtraction is also same. Subtraction, the process of subtraction is also same like addition. First, if the denominators are not same, to do the subtraction of two fractions, their denominators must be equal, same. Okay? If they are not same, then find their LCM and make denominator equal to that LCM. So here, what is LCM of 12 and 21? 12 and 21 we have found in previous example. What is that?
84, right?
So here we have to make denominator 84 in both the fraction.
So 5 upon 12, first fraction I am writing here. 12 multiplied by how many? 84. 12 multiplied by 7. So here in the denominator we have multiplied by 7. In the numerator also we need to multiply by 7. Minus 4 upon 21. 21 multiplied by how many? 84? 4 zar. So here also multiply by 4. Okay. Now see. 12 sevens are 84. 5 sevens are 35. Minus 12 fours are 84, 4 fours are 16.
Are there same denominators? Fine. Now we can subtract. Take denominator common. Subtract only numerators, okay? So 35 minus 16 is 19 upon 84. 19 upon 84 is the subtraction of difference between this 5 upon 12 and 4 upon 21. Understood? Next. Practice this. Okay. 5 upon 8 plus 2 upon 23. Denominators are not same. We need to make denominators same. For that, find the LCM of 8 and 23. What is LCM of 8 and 23? What is LCM of 8 and 23? What is LCM of 8 and 23? We have found in previous example, previous question. What was that?
184.
Okay. So here we have to make denominator 184. For that we need to multiply 8 by which number? 23. Because it is prime number, right? 23 8s are 184. So here also by 23. Plus 2 upon 23. 23 into 8, 184. So here also multiply by 8. 23 8s are 184. And 23 5s are 115, correct? 5 3s are 15, 1 carry 5, okay, correct. Plus 23 8s are again 184, and 8 2s are 16. Now see, denominators are same in both the fractions. Take it common, 184, and add only numerators, 115 plus 16, that is 131 upon 184. Understood? Next. 4 upon 9, minus 1 upon 6. Again, the denominators are not same. Need to find LCM of 9 and 6. What is LCM of 9 and 6? 18. We have found in previous question.
Now LCM of 9 and 6 is 18. That means we have to make denominator 18. So 4 upon 9, 9 multiplied by how many 18? 9 2s are. So 4 2s are. Minus 1 upon 6, 6 multiplied by how many 18? 3s are. So 1 3s are. So 4 2s are 8, 9 2s are 18. Minus 3 1s are 3, 6 3s are 18. Denominators are same now. Take it common. 8 minus 3. That is 5 upon 18. Understood? So in this way, we have to do the addition and subtraction of fraction. If the denominators are same, then it's easy to add or subtract. But if the denominators are not same, then we have to go by this way. Find LCM of denominators. We have to make denominators same. Otherwise, we cannot add or subtract the two fractions, two or more fractions, if the denominators are not same. Okay. So we have to make their denominator same by finding LCM. Whichever LCM we will get, make denominator equal to that LCM, and according to which do the needful calculations. Okay. So if you don't understand, watch again and again. Even you have doubt in this, you can ask me. Okay. So thank you for today. Have a nice day.